Hi, everybody. I'm Jen Johnson, and I am the host for Thought by Thought Healing. The last time I was on here, I talked about how your pain is produced in your brain, and it can be produced both as a response to physical structural damage, but also to emotional turmoil. So unresolved emotions, trauma, repressed emotions, or even conscious fear, anger, guilt, sorrow can cause a fight or flight nervous system response, which when chronically activated can become pain and many other symptoms. COVID-19 is the prime cause of underlying low-grade stress that can activate that fight or flight response. But today I want to talk about the fact that that pain response that the brain is causing can become habitual. It can become learned and become a cyclical response of the brain. Neuroscientists are calling this predictive coding. This is a very big subject, but boiled down for the purposes of today, it is the fact that your brain is the one that produces all your sensations. So your vision, your taste, your hearing, your pain, and others are produced in the brain, not in the body part. So an example is your vision. You do not see in your eyes with your eyes. Your eyes take in the information, the light waves, and send them to your visual cortex, which is in your brain, where your brain interprets it and includes all the other times that you have been in the situation that you are in. It uses everything you saw then and creates a new experience for you today, but it's based on all those past experiences. The same is true of pain. Because you've experienced pain for so long, your brain is now cyclically taking the data that it knows. This is what we do. This is what happens. And it's actually your brain's way of protecting you from having to work too hard. But in this case, it's not helpful because it is causing pain, which you don't want. The good thing is that we can change that response and teach our brains that there's a new way of doing things. So I like to use the example of a cell phone. We learn pain in the same way you learn anything else, how to ride a bike, and how to use your phone. When you get a phone, it has specific software on it, and you learn how to use it. Your thumbs learn how to operate. You know where the certain apps are. You set it up to where you don't really have to think about things. You just do it. Your motor cortex makes your thumbs move in the way that makes using your phone effective. And when there's a new software update and that sends you that little notification, I like freak out because I don't want to learn a new thing. I don't want to unlearn the old way of doing things. I want to keep going with that. And I don't want to learn this new thing. But in the case of pain, it's a great thing to learn a new response, to teach your brain that we're going to operate in a different way. And how you do that is it to interrupt the cycle of how you interact with your pain. Pain is produced as a protector when you are in emotional or physical danger. And we want to tell our brain that we are no longer in that danger and interrupt that cycle and tell it we don't need the pain anymore on this daily basis. Dr. Howard Schubiner studies pain, and he has come up with six F's that hinder healing. So here's his six F's. These are what stop healing, remember. Fearing it, focusing on it, being frustrated by it, figuring it out, fighting it, and fixing it. So those are the six F's that are not helpful. And we can replace those F's with things like curiosity and compassion, kindness. So you want to use a restful posture and almost talk to your pain. And when I was healing, I would say silly things like, "It's okay, wrist. I understand that this seam," because seams just killed me. I would say, "I'm okay. It's just a seam. A seam is harmless. Doesn't hurt anybody. And you're okay." So I would use kindness and compassion or curiosity. How interesting that my wrist is responding in this fearful way to this seam. And so having this posture of calmness can interrupt that cycle and teach your brain a new thing. similar to using a new app or a new software update on your phone. So that's how, in a very brief nutshell of a way, that your brain becomes cyclical with pain and how you can interrupt. That's one way that you can interrupt the cycle. There's a lot of other different tools to help interrupt that cycle of pain, but this is one, and I hope that it is helpful for you today. So thanks for tuning in, and I'll be back on here in a week. Thanks for watching. Bye.